landed at LAX expecting the glam and glitz of a Hollywood premiere. Red carpets, cheering fans, and paps taking me photo, asking for autographs. But it was none of that waiting for me. Only Chaz in his bloody cab. He said some studio development exec tipped him off. There's a supernatural disturbance at play, and this time, it was personal. He was told that show creators Daniel Cerrone and David Goyer had gone missing, and the rising darkness was behind it. I followed the scry map to a seedy back alley on the outskirts of downtown. When I arrived, the lousy map led me to a dumpster filled with the like. Bottoms up. That's the thing about fishing through trash. It is the part of your history you prefer the world not to know about. Yet I always find myself knee-deep in it. When I looked up, she was standing there, hiding in the shadows.
It was none other than Rosa Carnes.
I hadn't laid eyes on that demonic little beauty since I gave her the old rumpy pumpy back in Atlanta. Reckon she moved on to another bloke by now, but what was she doing here?
I'm headed to the pub. It's around the corner. They've got a TV there. Was gonna watch your show, John. I didn't believe it, but it's true. NBC made a show about your life. Wanted to see where I played into it. Your life, I mean.
Poor sod. I might have joined her, but I have better things to do on a Friday night. Besides, Cerrone and Goya are missing. And it's up to yours truly to find them. Well, that's the end of me.
The end? What do you mean?
I tried to tell the lovey, if those wankers aren't writing me show for broadcast, then I'll cease to exist as I know it. But she didn't seem worried.
Come on, John. There's always Hellblazer. Take your mind off of it. Have a drink with me.
Her looks were intoxicating. It was hard to say no. Felt as if I was falling into a trance. I moved in towards her. I wanted a kiss, a wild urge. I couldn't fight until... Oh, bloody hell. Try putting myself back together. But when I finally got my bearings, she was gone. Little did I know, I had the first clue in the palm of my hand.